So we're in the terminal, we have got some coffees, I've got a matcha latte from each, and then some sandwiches as well. So chicken, avocado, and brown bread. Look how strong it is.
We are in Norway! We just landed about half an hour ago. We just got to the hotel. 6.5 hours
later. Morning guys, we're just at a hotel near the airport because we got here pretty late last night in Norway. Gotta get some breakfast.
Omelette. Wow, they have so many different types of egg. They've got boiled, they've got red, they've got omelette, sausage, and chicken meatballs. Potatoes and fried mushrooms. Ooh, porridge. They've got an actual crepe or pancake thing, and it's hot. You can, the batter's here, and you can make it yourself. And there's some already made as well. They got lots of fish and cured meats, cold meats and cheese. Okay, so I got a little bit of most things. I got, I think it's a mushroom, pepper and leek omelette, baked beans, potatoes, a chicken meatball, sausage and bacon. Potatoes are nice. I've got some flavouring on it, I don't know what it's called. Tastes nice. It is like a frankfurter, but it's more... It's not as soft as a frankfurter, it's more like... That makes sense. Mmm, I like the meatballs. Flavoured really nice.
I thought I'd start off a bit healthy with some muesli with some fruits. It's got coconut flakes, it's got banana flakes, and it's got raisins as well. It's with some milk. Breakfast is still 10:30 a.m. It's 10 past 10 to be fair, 20 minutes, but they've got no potatoes, they've got no sausage. I'm really upset.
Well, you should have went earlier instead of Friday night.
So instead, just got one little meatball, chicken meatball, some sausage, no, some bacon, beans, mushrooms, and a ham and cheese omelette. They look like they had a lot of selection if you get there early. Just an omelette. A bit dry because I think it's been sitting out there for a while. It's alright.
So I was looking around and I found this little thing. Oh, by the way, the man's bringing you potatoes.
They've got loads of mushrooms.
Is that actually?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So where's the potatoes?
They're bringing out new potatoes.
Anyway.
Yeah, I found this. I don't really know what it is. It smells like some sort of yogurt. Some sort of berry yogurt, maybe? Oh, it's a very light texture, actually. Mmm, that is really nice. I don't know what it is, but it tastes good. I think it's like a mousse, it's quite light. Well, that bit on top is light. The bit at the bottom is more thick, but it's really creamy. I don't really know what it is, but it's nice.
So I just took two pancakes fresh off the whatever that's called. They smell really good. Now I'm gonna toss it with some stuff. Don't really know.
Maybe Nutella.
They've got Nutella, they've got peanut butter, they've got cinnamon sugar, maple syrup.
A dash of cinnamon, yeah?
Got more potatoes.
Yeah.
That's very nice of the chef to deliver some personal potatoes to me. How hot? Worth the wait.
So one's got Nutella. I know that looks really weird. One's just got maple syrup and cinnamon. It's okay. It's not the best pancake I've ever tasted. I mean, I think it smelled better than it tastes. We are on the fourth floor on the deck, which has a nice little view. The view is quite nice, but we are near the airport, so it's not amazing. We are now in Stavanger, I think that's how you pronounce it, and we're making our way to the city centre. Have a look. We came across this really nice fountain and we realised that there's always music playing out loud. Like in the hotel we stayed at last night, they just had music playing outside, and same here. There's a 7-Eleven! There's a little wedding going on.
So here is our Airbnb in Stavanger, where we're going to be staying for the next 2 nights. Let's take you on a little tour. So this is the living room slash bedroom as well, because there is a sofa bed, which we've actually already opened up. Then we've got the kitchen, which is quite nice, quite modern. Not the biggest apartment, but it's like all right for 2 days, not too bad. So that's quite nice, got a little table as well. Now into the bathroom. It's kind of like a wet room, so there's a shower there. It's also got a washing machine. And then the toilet and the sink, and a nice big mirror as well. So that's the bathroom. And then this only has one bedroom, technically. Let me turn the light on. There you go. Yeah. So decent. Look how big this mattress is though.
Show the wardrobe.
And then you've got a nice big mirror, if you look that way. Decent sized mirror, but the best bit about this is if you open that up, it's a walk-in wardrobe. And then I like the fact you can dim it and then brighten it like that. So, you know, decent size wardrobe for all your clothes.
Okay, bye.
Excuse me.
Bye.
Excuse me, can you let me out please? And that's basically the apartment tour. Not much to it, but nice little cozy place for 2 days in Stavanger, which is the first destination in Norway.
We're just walking to the town centre.
Yeah, dropped our bags off at the Airbnb.
Yeah.
And we are going to do a bit of exploring basically.
I don't know what he's doing. So in Norway right now, it's about 11 degrees. Yeah, so it's a lot colder than back home in London, because the past week in London has been quite sunny and hot, about 20 degrees.
Oh, we're in a little sweet shop now. There's loads of different sweets.
We're gonna get a few sweets that we've never seen before or had before and try them later.
What are those?
I don't know. I'm just picking random stuff that I've never seen before.
We got a little bag of sweets and then we also got a mochi ice cream to try.
Okay, so I'm going to try the mochi ice cream. We got just normal vanilla flavour. It should be ready now. We have to wait about 5 minutes for it to melt a little bit. I reckon the mochi is chewy, the ice cream is nice and creamy. I really like it. First time trying mochi ice cream.
We are now at Norse Museum. I don't actually know what the museum is about, but we can go inside and have a little loop.
Okay, we're gonna spin her and then see if she can walk in a straight line. Walk in a straight line. I don't know where we are exactly, but we've come to a nice, pretty part of the town. Look at all the different colours of the different shops. It looks like quite a busy night with restaurants. Let's go check it out. Oh, look at the dog. Mom.
Aww, doggo.
There's a bike race going on in this town and it's on Norwegian TV. And I think we're at the end where they're going to be coming through. An Italian restaurant called Olivia. I've been walking around for ages trying to find a restaurant. I'm so hungry. Because we haven't really eaten anything since breakfast. So, very hungry.
So I got the linguine with scampi and it's also got cream and you get a slice of focaccia bread on the side, which is amazing. So I'm gonna put some pop up. That is really good. Perfectly cooked, al dente. Just really nice, very rich, but really tasty. And I'm gonna try to put focaccia in there. Very springy, that focaccia. Goes well with the pasta as well on the side.
I got penne with chicken and bacon in a tomato sauce. I can get it. It smells really good. So good. Sauce is creamy and rich and tomato-y. Pasta is cooked perfectly. Chicken is tender. Bacon is nice and salty. That is really good. Really good pasta dish. Pizza with nduja sausage, basil, mozzarella, and on a tomato base. The dough is so thin, crispy on the outside, but it's still chewy.
the sausage gives a little spiciness. It is just really good.
We got the panna cotta with raspberry pudding for dessert. It looks pretty nice. Oh, that's good. It's a perfect amount of like perfect consistency, because some are too hard and not creamy enough, but this one is very creamy, and that shot raspberry pudding cuts through it really nice. So we are in the supermarket called Spa. You get your bread basically, and they have a bread machine so you can slice it. So this is some kind of wholemeal bread. Pop the bread and out comes your slices. And that's how you slice bread, people. Well, if you have a bread machine.